Good morning, students. Today we are moving to chapter 9, that is hydrogen. So we are moving to chapter hydrogen. So what are the learning outcomes of this chapter? So after learning this chapter, what you'll come to know? We will be knowing the position of hydrogen in the periodic table. Then we will come to know how to prepare hydrogen. So we will be knowing about the preparation of hydrogen. Then we will be knowing the properties of hydrogen. So properties include physical properties and chemical properties, and we will be knowing the uses of hydrogen. So these are the learning outcomes of hydrogen. So you will know the position of hydrogen in the periodic table. You will be knowing the physical and chemical properties. You will know how to prepare hydrogen, and we will be knowing what are the uses of hydrogen. Also, we will be knowing the isotopes of hydrogen. So we will also know the isotopes of the hydrogen. So these will be the learning outcomes of this chapter, hydrogen. Now, moving to the first point, that is position of hydrogen in the periodic table. So we are going to see in detail the position of hydrogen in the periodic table. When you look into the position of hydrogen in the periodic table, it is not justified. Why the position of hydrogen in the periodic table is not justified? Because it is resembling alkali metals as well as halogens. The position of hydrogen in the periodic table is not justified. Why? Because the hydrogen is resembling your alkali metals as well as halogens. Now, how it resembles alkali metal? How I am saying that my hydrogen is similar to alkali metals? What are the points which tell me that my hydrogen is resembling alkali metal? Point number one, my hydrogen's electronic configuration is 1s1, which is similar to that of alkali metals. Okay. Number two, it is a good reducing agent. So how about its reducing property? It's a very good reducing agent. That's why I am bringing it under alkali metals. Number three, your hydrogen has the ability to lose one electron. As a result, if I lose one electron, means what happens? Which charge will be predominating in me? Plus charge will be predominating in me. So I will become H+. This is also similar to that of alkali metal. Then, when you electrolyze your hydrogen containing compounds like hydrogen chloride, hydrogen plus and chloride minus will be liberated. If I am going to do electrolysis, electrolysis is passing electrical current. As a result, the compound will be lysed. Lysed means broken. So I will be getting H+ and Cl minus, where your H+ will be going towards your negative electrode. Negative electrode is nothing but your cathode. And chloride minus will be going and deposited towards the positive electrode. The positive electrode is called as anode. This is also similar to that of your alkali metals. Fifth property, my hydrogen is electropositive. So how it is? It is electropositive like alkali metals. And what about its oxidation state? It shows +1 oxidation state like alkali metals. So these are the 6 properties which tell that my hydrogen is resembling alkali metal. How is it? Its electronic configuration is 1s1. It is a good reducing agent. It can lose one electron. As a result, it forms H+. And when you do electrolysis, you will be getting a positive ion and a negative ion, which will be deposited to the corresponding positive and negative electrode. And it is electropositive in nature, and it shows +1 oxidation state. So these are the properties which makes my hydrogen that it is resembling halogen. Next, I am telling the property, I mean the position of hydrogen cannot be justified. Why? Because it is same like alkali metal as well as like halogen metal. These are the properties which shows that my hydrogen is similar to alkali metal. Now I am going to list out the properties which tells me that my hydrogen is similar to halogen. See how it is resembling halogen. It is a non-metal. Okay, my hydrogen is a non-metal. This is the first property which shows that my hydrogen is resembling halogen. Now, what is the second property? It is able to form diatomic molecule, H2Cl, like that. So it has the ability to form a diatomic molecule. It is a gas like your halogens, fluorine, chlorine, etc., right? So it is a gas. It is a gas like fluorine and chloride gas. Now it not only loses electron like how it resembles alkali metal, it can also gain electron. So it has the ability to gain one electron to form H minus ions, and it is electronegative in nature. And it is liberated at the anode when you do electrolysis. Okay, so when you do electrolysis of NaOH, it will be liberated at the anode. So this property shows that it is similar to that of halogen. Now it shows -1 oxidation state. It shows -1 oxidation state, and it has the ability to form covalent compounds. So it has the ability to form covalent compounds. So these 8 properties tell me that my hydrogen is similar to that of halogen. So what are the 8 properties? It's a non-metal like halogen, it's a diatomic molecule, it's a gas like fluorine and chlorine, etc. It can gain one electron and become H minus ion. It is electronegative in nature. It can form, when you do electrolysis, it will be deposited at the anode. It shows -1 oxidation state, and it can form covalent compounds like halogens. So we have completed with our first point. I have justified my statement telling hydrogen is similar to alkali metal as well as halogens. This is done. Now moving to our second point, preparation. So I just want to clarify that preparation of hydrogen, physical property and chemical property, is not there for your final exam. So these are not there for our final exam, but let us go to an outline. Like I'll just want to list out the important points under preparation, physical and chemical properties. Moving to the preparation of hydrogen. You know the formula for hydrogen is H2, right? So how to prepare hydrogen? You need to prepare hydrogen from water, correct? No? So my first step in preparation of hydrogen is, when I add water molecule to any of the mineral acids, okay, like sodium, say for example sodium, I am going to treat my water with sodium, so I will be getting sodium hydroxide, right? Because what is here? H is there and OH is there, so I'll be getting sodium hydroxide as well as hydrogen. The reaction is not balanced here, right? So I am going to balance the reaction, 2 water molecule and this is 2 sodium. So now this becomes 2 NaOH. Now the reaction is balanced. See, this reaction is said to be a vigorous reaction. I just want to reduce the reactivity, or I just want to reduce the rate of the reaction. So I'm going to use amalgam. You know what is an amalgam? Amalgam is nothing but an alloy along with mercury. So alloy of a metal along with mercury is called as amalgam, correct? So this is alloy of metal along with mercury. So how to prepare hydrogen, children? You need to react water molecule with the sodium, you'll be getting hydrogen. So this is one way. What is the other way of preparing hydrogen, especially in the laboratory? How will you prepare hydrogen? So in lab, hydrogen can be prepared by reaction of zinc granules with dilute HCl or dilute sulfuric acid. So I need to treat my zinc granules with HCl. So what will be the product, children? See, zinc and chloride will combine to give me zinc chloride plus my hydrogen will be liberated, right? When I'm trying to balance the reaction, so my reaction will be like this. So this is the second way, like how I'll be preparing hydrogen. What is the second way that how that I'll be preparing hydrogen in the laboratory? Treat zinc granules with the sulfuric acid or hydrochloric acid. I'll be getting zinc chloride plus hydrogen. What is the third step? See, I can treat metals like magnesium or zinc or aluminium with hot water, or I can treat them with the steam. So when water is hot or cold, or if it is steam, the formula will be H2O only, correct? So what is the third step? I'm going to treat magnesium, zinc or aluminium with hot water or steam. So what I'll be getting? I'll be getting corresponding metal oxides. I'll be getting magnesium oxide, or I'll be getting zinc oxide, or I'll be getting aluminium oxide, plus my desired compound hydrogen will be liberated. Clear? So what is the fourth step of preparing hydrogen? How do you prepare hydrogen by fourth step? That is, fourth step involves treating hydrogen with metal hydride. You know the formula for metal hydride, right? A metal along with the hydrogen is said to be metal hydride. Here specifically I am going to take sodium hydride. When sodium hydride is treated with water molecule, so this is like the reaction of the first reaction. See, I have sodium hydride and I have a water molecule. So sodium hydroxide will be liberated along with the hydrogen. Okay. So now moving to the last reaction of preparation of hydrogen. I have to treat methane molecule, that is CH4 is methane, with a steam. Treat methane with the steam. So what will I get, children? I'll be getting carbon monoxide and hydrogen. I'll be getting carbon monoxide and hydrogen. 6 hydrogen is here. So here 2, here 4, 6 done, and CO is liberated. So these are the 5 steps involved in the preparation of hydrogen. Let me sum up. First is treating water molecule with sodium. This is a vigorous reaction. In order to avoid, I have to add amalgam. Amalgam is nothing but an alloy of metal with mercury. Second is, in laboratory, you can treat zinc granules with a dilute HCl. I'll be getting zinc chloride and hydrogen. Third one, reaction of metals with hot water or steam. I'll be getting corresponding metal oxides along with hydrogen. Fourth step is treating metal hydrides with water. I'll be getting sodium hydroxide along with hydrogen. Then fifth step is treating methane with water molecule. I'll be getting carbon monoxide and hydrogen. So these are the preparation of hydrogen. Since I told you this is not there for final exam, I have just given you an outline. Now moving to the physical properties of hydrogen. See, as you all are aware, like what physical properties you will tell for water, you can just add few points to hydrogen too, because hydrogen is a colorless, odorless, tasteless gas, correct? No? Yeah, like water molecule, it is colorless, it is odorless, and it is tasteless. So this is about your physical properties. It is very lighter than air, it is combustible, and it is lightest of all elements, it is diatomic. So these are the physical properties of hydrogen. Now moving to the chemical properties, these three properties are not there. I mean your physical property, your preparation, and your chemical properties is not there for final exam. So I'm just highlighting the points, right? So moving to the chemical properties of hydrogen, what are the chemical properties of hydrogen? See, in room temperature, my hydrogen is less reactive. And as I discussed, it can form compound under suitable condition with almost all elements except one, you can tell me which element. The element which will not react with any element is called as inert elements, and our noble gases. So what I can tell you, your hydrogen has the ability to react with all the elements in the periodic table. It has the ability to react with all the elements of the periodic table, but except with noble gases. It will not react with noble gases, but it has the ability to react with all the elements of the periodic table. As a result, it can form compounds. Okay, so physical property: colorless, odorless, tasteless. It is very lighter than air and it is a diatomic molecule. Moving to chemical properties, it has the ability to react with all the elements of the periodic table except our noble gas elements. As a result, they will be forming compounds. Okay, children. So what we have seen, now we have seen the position of hydrogen. Okay. We have seen the position of hydrogen. I justified my statement telling my hydrogen is similar to alkali metal, my hydrogen is similar to halogen. That is done. Then I told you preparation of hydrogen. What did I tell you, children? I have told the preparation of hydrogen. Then I have discussed physical and chemical properties of hydrogen too. So uses, I'll be discussing it later because this is included for final exam. Uses is included for final exam. Correct. Now moving to isotopes of hydrogen. Now what we are going to see? We are going to see isotopes of hydrogen. We are going to look into the isotopes of hydrogen. For that we should know the occurrence of hydrogen. So now we are going to see the occurrence of hydrogen.